Thank you. Thank you, Nikita, basically for the confirmation over here and for basically starting the recording also over here. So we will proceed ahead with our demo session right now. Yep. And guys, I think all of you are able to hear me as well as see our trademark empty notepad screen, correct? Yeah, it will be filled shortly. Don't worry about it. Yeah, because some of you, I think, have already, you know, like attended our Ariba demo session over there and the Ariba sessions also. So you know that we always like to use the notepad from scratch. Yeah, it will be empty when we will start our session. By the end of the session, it will be totally filled up. Yeah. Yeah. Thank you for your confirmation over here, guys. So today, it's slight off topic because most of you are basically coming from the realm of Ariba. Now today, basically all of you are coming into SAP Fieldglass. So basically all of you are interested in SAP Fieldglass, but the first and foremost thing which comes in your mind over here is, what do you mean by Fieldglass? Why Fieldglass is used? So before going into the technical things, let's try to understand where Fieldglass will be used or what is the need for Fieldglass within the current ecosystem of all the SAP software which is present over there. Excuse me. Now, if you compare the specifically, I am talking about the employee base, the workforce, employee workforce. I'm not talking about one organization. I'm talking about majority of the, you know, job. You look at the job over there. Is there any difference compared to 2019 versus 2021? If you look at the job market and if you basically think of these things from 2019 versus 2021. Now, most of you will say yes. We are noticing some major difference. What is the major difference? The major difference which all of you are basically seeing over here is what? That in 2019, there were somewhere around what? Excuse me. 60% of the job was basically permanent. 40% was contractual. Now specifically, contractual means what? As a third party consultant or as a normal consultant over there. Okay. Very good. But you come to 2021. Now what is happening? There has been a, you know, steady job erosion in 2020. Okay. That's the first thing. Second thing is basically from this year onwards, all of you are going to argue with me by saying that, you know, the job market is looking good over there. And due to this particular thing, what is happening? Jobs are coming like anything, if not at 100%. Still at a different rate. Then I will say yes. But look at the job. 80% of the job is contractual. 20% of the job is permanent. That means as a full-time employee, out of 10 jobs, out of 100 jobs, only 20 people are supposed to receive a permanent job. 80% will be contractual. It means either they will be a contractor or a third-party contractor. Okay. So, Manoj, why you're talking about this? Because officially speaking, Fieldglass is nothing but a VAS. Vendor management system. But the term used over here is very, very, what you can say. Okay. So, first and foremost thing, which all of you, just a moment, guys. Am I audible now? Am I audible properly and clearly? Okay. first and foremost thing, as I was basically talking about there in SAP Fieldglass, for the job market over there, look at the current job offering right now. In 2019, the breakage of permanent job was something around 60%. Contractual job was somewhere around the range of 40%. I'm not talking about India. I'm talking about something which is basically related to related to all over the world in 2019. Okay, that's the first thing. Now look at 2021. The 2021 has been totally changed. Permanent job is very less. It's somewhere around 20%. And contractual job is basically 80%. When? In 2021. Now, okay, Manoj, why you are talking about job over here? For SAP Fieldglass and all those particular thing. Excuse me. So in that case, I will basically tell you the meaning, but before that, let us try to understand a little bit specific things. Now, what is that particular specific thing? That specific thing which all of you guys have to understand is, as a permanent job, what will happen? You will get PF and all those things. But from a point of view of organization, what is happening? You're getting full-time benefits. Your onboarding, offboarding activities, everything will be different. But on the other hand, if you are a contractual employee, now you will not have too many benefit. Second thing is, do you think you will be onboarded just like a permanent employee over there? No. You go to any organization over there and you ask them over there that, boss, how you deal with contractual employees? So they will immediately say, Manoj, our HR system over there and the other systems over there is not fully equipped to handle this contractual employee. Why? Because the whole process is manual in nature. Why? Basically, from selecting the proper employee, onboarding the proper employee, and then making them work, deliver the work, pay them, and then offboarding them. This thing is totally done manually. Now you can understand the impact. In 2019, it was 40% of the total workforce. Look at 2021. What is the impact over here? 80%. Excuse me. That means for 80% of the workforce, everything is happening manually, one by one step down the line. And that is causing a lot of issue, lot of efficiency, lot of loss of money. So to basically make sure to take care of this contractual job as well as contractual employee, what is the solution? SAP Fieldglass. What is SAP Fieldglass? All of you will ask me. Then I will say it's a VMS, vendor management system, plain and simple. But what does this vendor management system do? So vendor SAP Fieldglass is that particular solution. Okay. Through which contractors or third party contractors, we can manage these contractors and third party contractors from, or you can say लाइफ साइकिल ऑफ कॉन्ट्रैक्टर्स, थर्ड पार्टी कॉन्ट्रैक्टर्स ओवर देयर. ओके, नाउ आई थिंक ऑल ऑफ यू गॉट द मीनिंग, बेसिक मीनिंग ऑफ व्हाट एसीपी फील्ड डस. नेक्स्ट टाइम बेसिकली ऑल ऑफ यू विल अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ फील्ड डस. बट नाउ द इश्यू इज all of you are basically coming from Ariba background, procurement background. So why you want to learn SAP Fieldglass? Which is clearly, if you have a look at it, all of you will basically say this is nothing but, you know, handling the whole life cycle of the contractor, third party contractor. That means like contractual employees. Handling this software is basically designed to handle the contractual employees. Now all of you who are basically from Ariba, that means you are from procurement department, all of you are coming towards me and saying, Manoj, why you're talking about almost HR related thing to a procurement related thing? Excuse me. Now majority of you guys are basically thinking that this contractual job will be released through HR portal. Then I will say yes, correct. But who raises this request? See, for a full-time job profile over there, what will happen? The delivery team will basically share this requirement with the HR team. HR team will get the approval from different people over there. The HR team will basically look for the resumes, ask the basically candidates to come for the interview, then they will get a job offer, and then they will be what? Then only they will be onboarded into the system, or not system, into the organization over there. But what about this contractual services or contractual employees over there? So that is where all of you should be very, very clear. It's not like a HR process. It's never a HR process. It's never a HR process. So what is it? It is a advanced services procurement. What will happen? The procurement team will basically do what? They will basically create a purchase requisition where they will say services of Ariba consultant, 3 in quantity required over there. What he will do? This kind of procurement PR is basically raising over there. What are you going to do? I basically within the PR, you will see free catalog item. Now, like this particular PR is getting created. How are you going to handle them in Ariba? This is an example of your advanced services procurement, guys. And frankly speaking, you cannot handle this thing in Ariba, neither in ERP. So how it will be handled? This will be handled through the Fieldglass. Now this particular PR is what? Against this particular purchase equation, once the PR has been created, before that thing, there will be certain process where within Fieldglass, and then after creating the PR and the PO will get created, there will be certain processes which will happen in your Fieldglass also. So that is what, from the point of view of a procurement guy, what I will say, software for this is basically the meaning of fillers from the procurement section. Exactly. So all of you should be very, very clear on this part. This should be basically from the procurement point of view. If you look at SAP filler from procurement point of view, this is the meaning of SAP filler, nothing else. Okay. Now, within fillers, there is two main process. The first one is statement of work. Okay. That is the first option over there. And the second option is basically what? Contingent workforce management. Now, of course, there are two URL over there, but one will be for the testing URL, one will be for the production. So here also you will be having buyers login, suppliers login. All of you will say, Manoj, it looks like Ariba. Then I will say worker login. So Manoj, are you talking about just like in Ariba, Ariba buyer, Ariba network? Here also fillers network, then fillers worker? No. Remember, in fillers you will have only one URL. There is no two different application. Yes, according to our basically definition of fillers, sometimes we will use a different name over there, but remember the URL is same. Excuse me, guys. So first and foremost thing is buyer will log in into supplier, will also log in into fillers URL. Worker will also log in into fillers URL. Okay. Now, who is a buyer? I think all of you can say to me that, Manoj, the particular users or employees belonging to the client who is implementing SAP fillers. Exactly correct, buyers. But what does supplier mean over here in fillers? Any guess, guys? Now, all of you are basically you have to have a look at it and you have to understand. Now, supplier over here does not mean who is basically, you know, responding to your PR and who is responding to the PO over here. See, technically speaking, all of you can argue with me by saying, yes, Manoj, the guy who is providing the services, that is basically called a supplier. But then again, you have to understand in fillers, supplier actually means consultancy organization, or you can say company. Now, what do you mean by this consultancy organization or company? For example, you want to implement Ariba. For implementing of Ariba over there, we will need four resources. Okay. Let's say where for Procter & Gamble. And Procter & Gamble is having this fillers. So what the buyer will do, they will basically create a job posting where they will be saying, boss, I need 4 Ariba consultant with this much amount of experience, and these are the things which they should be having their knowledge. Then what they will do, they will publish it to the supplier. Now, who is the supplier? Supplier is, for example, Source One, Vicentric organizations. These are what? These are consultancy companies who will basically receive this request, and they will try to catch hold of different Ariba consultant. They will call you up. Hey, are you interested in doing this thing? If you say yes, then they will say, okay, I'm going to make you arrange, you know, basically attend a interview over there. So this consultancy organization / company is nothing but a supplier in Fieldglass. So please don't remember or basically think over here, Fieldglass and Ariba supplier is same. No, here in Fieldglass, these are the consultancy organization who will catch hold of different consultants, make them attend the interview. Once the interview they have got selected, what they will do? They will basically do what? Give this consultant to the buyers, or you can say buying organization, so that this guy can work for the buying organization. Yeah. Now, some of you will say, Manoj, we can also say that these consultancy companies are going to make this consultant their employees. Then I will say that is one scenario. There is another scenario where the operational control, where it will lie for that particular consultant, that also can be defined. It can be either with the consultancy company, it can be either with the buying organization also. Exactly, that will depend. We will discuss this thing in our session only, discuss this thing in detail. But as of now, who is a consultancy organization or a company who will basically search for this consultant, bring them to the interview. Once the interview has been done, they will basically sign the contract with this particular consultant over there. Exactly. Just like, let's say in Accenture or in KPMG, you will go, you will see there is permanent employee and contractual employees. How are these contractual employees coming over there? They're basically coming from the consultancy organization or company. Different things like, you know, Vicentric, Source One, they will be basically Magna Infotech. They will basically onboard them on their behalf, on behalf of Accenture or KPMG over there. Exactly. Now, who is a worker? The worker is nothing but the consultant itself. Okay, so next time when you see this particular terminology over here, please remember worker is nothing but the contractual employee, or you can say contractors. Exactly. So these are the three most important thing. These are also same from Ariba. Okay, so these are the three basic things all of you should be knowing it in Fieldglass. If you don't know this thing, you cannot work. Now, okay, Manoj, let us come to these two major business process. Okay, what do you mean by these three, you know, these two division of process? Statement of work and contingent workforce management. Now, how many of you know Ariba? You can basically share your views over here in the chat box, guys. How many of you know Ariba? If I ask this particular question, what would be your answer? Excuse me. Exactly. Majority of you are saying that you know Ariba. Okay, next question. How many of you know SuccessFactors? How many of you know SuccessFactors, guys? I think you can either say yes or no over there. How many of you know it? Yeah. Some of you are saying, Manoj, we don't know it. Why? Why you don't know about success factor? Because all of you will say, Manoj, that is basically a, you know, HR related tool. So what do you want? We are basically procurement guys. Exactly. So what do you want us? Like we will understand every cloud solution which is offered from, you know, SAP side. Exactly. So let's say if I ask all of you guys, since all of you know about Ariba, hire a Ariba consultant. All of you will be very, very happy. Manoj, yes, I am very happy to basically hire some Ariba consultant over there. Why? Because you know about them. Next thing, I ask all of you guys, hire a success factor consultant. Will it be that easy for all of you guys? No. Now, basically, if I'm asking all of you guys, hire a mainframe developer. All of you will say, Manoj, I am having no idea about it. So how I will take the interview? How I will basically onboard the best consultant over there? So in that scenario, you will say to me, Manoj, we will need some help from some professional. So the statement of work over here basically talks about those requirements which is technically on the other hand, for contingent workforce management, contingent workforce means here the requirement is technically well known to the buying team. But this, for the statement of work, what will happen? That technically, requirements are not known at all. So what will happen? So here you will say, Manoj, like if you ask me to create a statement of work, I am not supposed to have this particular thing, like that, you know, the technicalities over there. So what? Let's say, for example, all of you are working in IT organization. Now I ask all of you guys, basically, create a contractor positions for what you can say. For those particular workers who are going to work on what? Basically, on increasing or adding three more floors to your headquarter building. So your headquarter building is having till seventh floor. Now, basically, due to some requirement, you want to add another three floor, eighth floor, ninth floor, and tenth floor over there. So you want to basically take the services of what you can say 15 laborers over there. This laborer will be working on the 8th, 9th and 10th floor over there. Can you define what you will ask this laborer? Hey, do you know how to apply, you know, cement? You know how to basically, you know, put a brick on the cement? What mixture of sand and cement you will do it? Can you ask this thing? No. But does it means you will not be able to, you know, take the, you know, what you can say, like generate the request for their 15 services of the laborer or services required for, you know, from 15 laborers. So yes, you have to generate this thing. So in this scenario, statement of work, you can say requirement is not technically known over here. That's the first thing. What's the next thing? Next thing basically, just a moment. Next thing over here is, guys, for the statement of work, you can say, "Are Not actually consultants. I'm just writing like this can represent anybody. I think rather than writing the consultant, I will write the terminology the worker. Operational control of what? Of the buying organization. The worker will not be under the operational control of the buying organization. So it will be under the control of whom? It will be under the control of So in this case, if you are saying over here that boss, if you are going to take the services of 15 laborers who is going to work on your 8th floor, 9th floor and 10th floor over there, what will happen? You will say, Manoj Construction Work, this is your supplier. Okay, so what you will do, you will ask your supplier over there, consultancy organization, Manoj Construction Work. Boss, I think we are not knowing properly about this, what? This, how to make a plaster, how to make a brick and how to make all those things. So these 15 laborers will be under your operational control. Why? Because we cannot supervise the work because we are not having knowledge about it. But I think all of you can understand when the 8th floor will be completed. Once the work is completed for the 8th floor, all of you can basically see over here that yes, your work is done. That means those 15 laborers has completed the work for the 8th floor. Then after some time, you can notice that the 9th floor work has been completed. Then after some time, the 10th floor work will be completed. So that means as a buyer, all of you can understand one thing over there, that in case of statement of work, what will happen? We will not know about the services which is to be provided by this workers, but that will be known by the suppliers slash consultancy organization over there. Okay, that's the first thing. The second thing is over there, what we will do, we will make sure that we are selecting some milestones. There can be different type of milestone, like percentage of work which is completed, event and all those particular thing, which once get completed, okay, that means one milestone is completed. That means it represents 25% of your work is completed. Very good. Second milestone is completed. That means it represents 50% of the work is completed. Third milestone is completed. That means it represents 75% of work is completed. And the fourth milestone completed. That means the full work has been completed over there. But this is easy. Why? Because as a buying team, we are just giving this option to the supplier. Supplier is making all these workers do their work. And once milestone is getting completed, they're informing us, go and check boss, done. So this is how the statement of work, you can say on a very high level. Yeah, there are a lot of, when you will see that we are going into the different processes, there are a lot of feedbacks over there in statement of work. But you can say that if you look at Earth, 20,000 kilometer above the Earth over there, what is the picture which we will get? Same picture is basically for the statement of work over here in today's session. There are a lot of things within the statement of work, but if you want to understand statement of work from a very high level, this is how you will understand. Very good. Now let us come to contingent workforce management. What is this contingent workforce management? The first and foremost thing which you can see is, which is requirement which is technically well known to the buying team. What do you mean by that? Which is technically known to the buying team over there. Now you want to hire some 5 resources. 3 is for Ariba, 2 is for Fieldglass. Then he will say, "Arey, bhaiya, I know about these guys. I know about the work which they are going to do. Either Ariba, Fieldglass also I am learning, but I can match it up over there." So that means this is technically well known to you as the buying team who is creating this request. And the second thing is, since the work will be done by you over there and your team, in this case, worker will be under the operational control of the buying organization. Okay, so please keep this thing in your mind over there. The workers will be under the operational control of the buying organization over there. And next, since all of you are saying here, who will do the work? The worker is basically working under the operational control of the buying organization. So here, instead of milestone, what we will do, we will ask the worker to fill the timesheet. Now, I think most of you as a employee know what is the meaning of timesheet, and all of you have to fill the timesheet to show that, okay, for this, excuse me, for this hour, how much work you have done, where you have done, why you have done, all those particular things. Correct? Exactly. So that is nothing but your timesheet over there. So you will ask this worker to fill the timesheet. Why? Because you know what are the different things, what are the different activity which this particular Ariba and Fieldglass consultant bracket workers, they are going to do. And once they fill the timesheet, you can approve them. Why? Not you can, you will approve them. You means what, guys? Just for your sake of understanding, what do you mean by you over here? I think it should be very much clear for all of you guys, but why? What do you mean by you in this case? Very good, buyer, or you can say buying organization or buyer. Very good, very, very good. Now, once the timesheet is approved, of course, the payment has to happen. Now, how the payment will happen, guys? Now, most of you will basically say, "Manoj, pay the worker." And I will say, you know, how you have onboarded this worker? If you are going to pay to the worker directly, you are gone case. Why? Because these guys will say, "Boss, what we are doing over here in this scenario? If you are going to pay to the worker directly, what we are going to do over here?" So always remember one thing: once the timesheet is approved, invoice, well, it depends. It can be auto invoice, also can be created. Manual invoice can also be created. supplier sent. Okay, remember, not from workers. Excuse me. It can be manually approved or it can be auto approved. Why? Because as per FILDAS, if the worker timesheet is approved fully, invoice should generally be automatically be approved over there. Okay, then what will happen? Payment will happen once again to whom? Now, once the payment to supplier happens over there, what will happen? Then supplier will take out his commission and pay the money to the worker over there, because that is how it happens. So when I was basically talking at the beginning of this session, contractual job, most of you were thinking, Manoj, what are you talking about? You're talking about the current market trend. I'm not talking about the market trend. I was basically explaining you that what are the use cases for FILDAS over there and why FILDAS is currently a very the growth rate of FILDAS over there is exponential. Actually, I will say right now, if you look at the growth rate of all SAP cloud solution, you will see FILDAS is in number one position. Why? Because as I say, that when the new jobs are getting added in this year, 80% of the new job is contractual. Now, all of your HR systems, they are not at all equipped to handle the onboarding and then working of this, but contract employees over there, how to onboard them, how to see whether they are doing their work properly or not, and then payment of money and all those things. Now, here, if I ask any of you guys, payment will happen to supplier. How? It's not like, you know, Ariba network, it's not like Ariba module over there, where I will say use Ariba Pay. There is nothing called as FILDAS Pay over here. So mandatorily, the payment has to be done in ERP. But now all of you will ask me over here, Manoj, this FILDAS can be directly be integrated with ERP. And I will say exactly correct. Then, where procurement is coming into the picture? Where procurement is coming into the picture? So I don't want to go into too much tough thing in today's session. Why? Because the thing is like, guys, Ariba was a very common thing, which like if you're coming from the MM and SRM background, from a functional point of view, it, you know, it would not have been a challenging thing for any of you guys. Yeah. The challenging thing was learning the on cloud premises, you know, on cloud solutioning part and a little bit change in process. But FILDAS, on the other hand, forget about the configuration. The process is totally different. Why? Because our requirement is totally different over here in FILDAS. So first and foremost thing, try to understand this thing. Why FG? FG means basically FILDAS. What is the relationship of Ariba with FILDAS? That you have to understand. Along with it, what is the relationship of FILDAS with ERP? And of course, if I ask over there, what is the relationship of Ariba to ERP? That all of you know. But this particular thing, holistically, the interrelation between these three systems, we should basically understand. That is very important. Now, I think if you look at both of these two requirements over there in FILDAS, this is the only two requirement. Yes, there are a lot of sub-processes over here which you need to understand. But generally, the process looks like this. Let's say we are having one requirement for work. Okay, this is generally called as what? दिस इज जनरली कॉल्ड इन फील्डलेस टर्मिनोलॉजी, दिस इज कॉल्ड एज ए जॉब पोस्टिंग. ओके, इन जॉब पोस्टिंग बेसिकली व्हाट वी विल डू, वी विल गिव ओके दिस मच अमाउंट ऑफ स्किल इज रिक्वायर्ड एंड बेसिकली 300 mandates is required or 200 mandates is required. Okay, for each mandate we are going to give somewhere around 100 USD per mandate over there. These are basically what, these are basically an examples of data which you will need within the job posting. Now once you give the requirement for work slash job posting over here, where you're doing this thing, you're doing this thing in FG. What he will do, you're basically doing this process over there. Okay, in FG you have done this thing, and then basically what you're doing, once this job posting has been created, you will edit, not edit actually, you can say fill up the data. Then basically submit and approval will happen. Okay, all of you are very, very happy that your things have been submitted and approved over here. Now where it will go? It will go to the supplier. Why? Because ultimately supplier will find you the worker over there, SOW worker or the normal contingent workforce management worker over there. So supplier all these things are happening in FG, huh? Okay, all of these things are happening in FG over there. What next? Very simple. Next is basically, once that has been done, what will happen? While the supplier is accepting the job posting over there, they will recommend workers. For what? For interview. Once they start recommending worker for the interview, what will happen? This is also happening in FG. Buyer will basically schedule the interview. Okay. Where it is happening? Once again, it is happening in FG over there. Okay, what next? Then basically, either they will hire them or reject them. Once again, where? In Fieldglass. And this can happen multiple times. Why? Because multiple workers can be, or basically multiple candidates can be selected over here. Now, once this has been done, what will happen? It needs the approval from the PMO team. Can any of you guys talk about this thing? What is the full form of PMO? Prime Minister Office, huh? PMO stands for Prime Minister Office or something else? Exactly, project management office. Yeah, just a moment guys. So basically, you will need the approval of the PMO team. Why? Because otherwise, I will say, hey, boss, to my project manager, I will say, actually, not the project manager. I will basically say to my vice president over there, hey, boss, Ravi, what I want to do is like, I want to hire a guy. Ravi will say, okay, you hire the guy, not an issue. Then Ravi give the approval. Ravi will anyhow give me the approval, not an issue. But if I don't take the approval from Ravi, what will happen is like I will basically put my favorite colleague over there and I will say, hey, this colleague should basically come as a third-party consultant into our what organization. Even though I know that particular guy is not having that much, you know, technical expertise over there, but I will help that guy. So that kind of thing can happen over there. So that is why the approval from the PMO team has to be taken. Why? Because PMO team will notice what are the things or how the interview went, what is the feedback and all those particular things. Once they approve it, so here, as per the fieldless work, what will happen? According to the fieldless process, work order will be created. This should not happen directly. It should always happen in an integrated process. So here, once the approval happens over there, what will happen? A break-in process. PR created in Ariba Buyer. Okay? Then approval. Once again, where? In Ariba Buyer. And then basically what will happen? PO will be created automatically. I think all of you know this thing, right? From the integration point of view. So in Ariba Buyer, this PO will be created. And what will happen? Now you are seeing work order will be created where in Fieldglass and it should be linked with the PO also over here in Fieldglass. That means this PO number from the Ariba Buyer side, it will come over here. Okay, very good, Manoj. So once this particular PO has been linked over there, and then what will happen? The work order has been created. Then what will happen? Then next step is timesheet submission by worker, which is happening once again in FG. Very good. Then what will happen? Timesheet approval. Once again, where? In FG. Okay, very good. Once it is approved, generally auto invoice. Once again in FG and linking in Ariba Buyer and Ariba Network. You are understanding what is happening over here. So this PO has been created over here in Ariba Buyer. Now the timesheet will be basically every month, the timesheet will be created and submitted by the worker. And then basically the buyer will approve it. Once it is approved, what will happen? Automatic invoice is getting created where? In Fieldglass. Then through the integration, this invoice will be replicated back into Ariba Buyer and Ariba Network. What will happen next? where it will happen? Ariba buyer, not an ERP. Then basically payment in ERP status update in Ariba buyer, Ariba network and fillers. Now remember this particular process over here, timesheet, submission and the payment every month. This is going to happen every month. First month, then second month, then third month, then fourth month. Why? Because you have basically hired this worker for, let's say, 1 year. So every month this will happen over there. And this integration touch point, you know, touch point will basically every month after the timesheet is submitted and then it is approved by the buyer, it will kick in. Exactly. So keep this thing in your mind. So this should basically happen through the approval. That means you look at this process over there, the integration process. I am not totally writing the complex process. I am just writing down the process in a very simple way, guys. You look at the process, what is happening. So this is the, basically, this is the meaning of this thing. That means how Ariba is in, you know, integrated with Fillers. Fillers is integrated with ERP. How is it? It is through this way. In a very simplified form, I have shown you over here. But in our integration scenario session, you will see we are going into much deeper things. Yes. So this kind of integration we have to do in a advanced Ariba implementation project. That is why I told all of you guys that when you were learning Ariba, that is a very normal Ariba over there. So most of you were basically saying, Manoj, that integration was a little bit tough. And I will say, what will you say to with this integration over there? Here, you have to do the integration in such a way within Ariba and Fieldglass that everything should work. Why? Because every month timesheet will get created, approved over there, and then this invoice reconciliation payment, and then the status update. Multiple invoice reconciliation, multiple invoices, multiple payment against the same PO. And that integration should work properly, not only with Ariba buyer, but with Ariba network and Fieldglass as well. So please don't think that this session is only for Fieldglass. Why? Because when we will go to the integration session, we will understand the scenario. The configuration is not only from Fieldglass side. It is both from Ariba buyer side also, and then from the Ariba buyer network. Now, all of you will say, what is Ariba buyer network? I think in our integration scenario, we have understood buyer.ariba.com. There also, you have to do integration for Fieldglass to work fine. Otherwise, your Fieldglass will not work. Exactly. So this particular process is what we will call as advanced services procurement, which will involve Fieldglass, Ariba, and ERP. And this is the future of your services procurement. I understood in 2019, 2018 only that this is the future of it, but all of you should understand that that future has already came right now. Why? Because of this COVID, what is happening is like every job market, you know, every job market is basically seeing contractual job in what? In force, in huge quantity. And this kind of configuration only have to work in over there. Exactly. Now, some of you will basically say, Manoj, what will happen if I don't use Fieldglass over there? So basically, yes, you are free. Basically, let's say earlier it was 4,000 employees, which was basically contractual. 6,000 is permanent. Now, let's say majority of these particular employees have been axed from their what? From their job. And now another 10,000 employees will be taken in. So 8,000 employees will be contractual. 2000 will be employees. Now for this 8000 employees, are you going to use a custom system, Java system for maintaining all these things? And if you are saying yes, then how you are going to do the payment manually? How much time it will be wasted? How much extra money you will give? How much your compliance activity will be done? Zero. And if you say I will use manual process, that means fill up the timesheet in Excel file over there, approve it over there, then do the payment manually, then you are gone. If you are using custom software, then also a huge disadvantage will happen over there. But if you are using manual process, working with documents and then taking the screenshot and keeping it and saving it over there, you are gone. These things will never work. So that is why what we are seeing right now in the market is, you know, the if you go into the market over there, you will see fieldglass opening is everywhere, coming over everywhere over there. Specifically, what we are seeing is like even the US organizations, they are not able to find a fieldglass consultant over there. But they are saying, you stay in India, you work for us only, you sign a contract with our organization only, stay in India, work from India only. We are going to give a good hike over there, but you work for us. Why? Because fieldglass employees, what this fieldglass consultant, what they are wanting over there, majority of the client, they are basically wanting this knowledge. This knowledge is not available in the market. That is why what I will say is like, how was Ariba in 2014-15? In 2014-15, there was requirement for Ariba over there in the market, but there was no supply of consultant. So anybody who is coming to the interview over there, they're able to say, okay, these are the basic things about Ariba. They will get a very good hike and they will get a job, which changed considerably from 2018 onwards. Exactly. Why? Because there was some supply of Ariba consultant in the market. Demand was also greater, but supply was also there. But in 2014-15, the supply was almost non-existent. Same thing also is there for fieldglass. Yeah, that demand is there, supply is zero. Exactly, supply is zero over there. So this is what you have to learn over here. I'm just giving an example. Now, some of you are going to say, Manoj, in your Ariba sessions, you went into much deeper things. Then I will say, yes, in fieldglass, we will go much more deeper. But remember, this is a totally new thing for all of you guys over there. Your point of view have to change basically, because when you're looking at any software over there, you're looking at it from a procurement software. Yes, this is also what you call as advanced services procurement. But here, not only the advanced services procurement is coming over here, a certain fact, or you can say certain percentage of HR related things also coming over here. So that if you're not clear and you're not able to factor that thing in, what will happen? Your project work will suffer a lot. So that is why we are going to go into this particular session in a step-by-step manner. Yeah, please don't expect that we are going to start with this integration. Why? Because all of you will lose your interest in this session if I start with this integration session. So in a step-by-step manner, we are going to make sure that all of you are what? Factoring in not only the service procurement section, but a little bit of HR section also, you are able to factor in over there. Why? Because fieldglass, what we do is like, we are going to basically make sure that only some Ariba consultant who are good in Ariba, they're coming over there. There's another part over there. We are also inviting some of the success factor consultant who are also having good knowledge in EC, Success Factor Employee Central. They can also come over there. Okay, but we will make sure that those of you who are from procurement background, that you should not suffer from the HR related thing. Similarly, some of the guys who are coming from the SuccessFactors EC section who want to learn SAP Fieldglass, we want to make sure that we are also giving them a basic overview of procurement so that they also should not miss out this full what Fieldglass related things over here. Exactly. So this is what we wanted to show in our demo over here, guys. I hope all of you got a basic understanding of what is Fieldglass. Yeah, this is not a full-fledged things over there, because in our first session also, that session will be overview session, but much more detailed session. There, I'm going to talk about much more technical things in Fieldglass. Exactly, but not in today's session. Why? Because today's session is, you can say, just the initiation. And the first session will be a deep overview. Then from the second session onwards, we are going to go into the system and we are going to see each and everything over there. Exactly. So guys, if you're having any queries or question on this part, you can raise your hand. We are going to take your queries right now. See, as of now, the regular sessions will be on the weekdays morning. Yeah, this is basically like, as of now, our first session right now for this year, what we are going to start, we are going to start with weekdays over there. Okay, as of now. This training is almost like, you know, 38 hours to almost like 40 hours, almost, you can say. No, not from tomorrow, not from tomorrow. I think this particular session, we are going to have our first session on Thursday morning. Yeah, on Thursday morning, we are going to have it, okay? And our full-fledged session will begin from next week. That means next week. That means not this week, next week onwards, our full-fledged session will basically start. Yeah. Yeah, you will get the server access, don't worry. We have got that particular access from the project over there. Don't worry about there, you will get it. Yeah, because see, if the access was not there, we would not have done this particular session only. Why? Because I think all of you know that in our session also, we will use that access to show everything over there. Yeah, without the system, we cannot work over there. Yeah, so all of you will basically see that Fieldglass access within our system. All of you will get that access also over there. Yeah. How to showcase Fieldglass experience? Now, as I said, our last session, basically, we will give you some hint how to basically include those particular points in the resume over there and how to work on that particular thing. Why? Because you are not going to see any resume with proper Fieldglass exposure. And yes, some are available over there. Again, but when it was not a SAP organization, Fieldglass, please don't think like SAP, you know, SAP has, you know, created this Fieldglass, just like Ariba. Ariba was a separate organization. In September 2012, it was what acquired by SAP. Fieldglass was a non-SAP company. This was acquired by SAP in December 2015. You can say from 2016 only it is present within the SAP ecosystem. Not very old. Yes, Ariba, you can say like September 2012, that means almost like 9 years. This is like 16 17 18 19 20 21, 5.5 years over there. Five and a half years over there. Yeah, so we will basically tell you how to basically prepare the resume and what are the points which you should increase over there. And of course, you are not going to find anything else in the market over there. And please don't copy also for those things over there. Why? Because I know what are the things which are available within the CV, within SAP Fieldglass experience. That thing, if you write over there, it will immediately get rejected over there. So we will help you in preparing your resume, guys. Yeah, because that hand-holding part, all of you will need. Why? Because you won't find any data or anything to write from the real, what you can say, in the real market over there, or you can say in anywhere, Monster or in Naukri also. So we will help you on that part. Yeah, any other queries, guys? You can go ahead and ask me over there. Or else, we can conclude our session for today. But remember, our first session will be a deep dive session. That will be also like some more information, but there we will use much more technical information. Exactly. Ankit, can you please go ahead with your query? You need to unmute yourself, Ankit. No, Ankit, I think we are not able to hear you. No. I have basically unmuted over here, guys. Yeah. It's not centrally muted over here. Yeah, I have unmuted. Ankit, I think I'm still not able to hear you over there. So I will urge you that can you basically type your query over there in the chat box? I'm going to read it and then I'm going to answer it. Still not able to hear anything. Okay, I think Ankit, there is some problem over there. Yeah. Okay, statement of work. So what do you mean by statement of work? So statement of work over there basically means, guys, that you are not having the full detail over there. Now let's say all of you are IT workers over there, okay, but your vice president is coming over there. They are saying, boss, 3 more floor needs to be constructed in our headquarter building. Take care of it. Take out a job posting over there, or basically take out a requirement where you say you need 15 laborers who can work on the 8th, 9th, and 10th floor and create it on our HQ building. So this is what basically your vice president is asking you. Now, any of you know what are the different activity which we need to do over there? No. So what you will do? You will basically call the supplier or the consultancy worker, Manoj Construction Private Limited. Manoj Construction Private Limited is very basically specialized to work on this particular thing. That means construction of different buildings, construction of different floors. Then he will say, boss, I don't know anything about it, but what I will do is like, I will make sure that once you complete the 8th floor, I will give 33% of the payment. Once you do the second floor over there, what I will do, I will release 33% of the payment. And once you complete the 3rd floor over there, what will happen? I will release the remaining of the amount over there. Okay, based on these three milestone, I'm going to give you the payment. So then your supplier, Manoj Construction Workers, Private Limited, will say, very good. So what they will do, they will hire some 15 laborers, this 15 laborers will work according to the Manoj Construction Private Limited. Why? Because you don't have any expertise on that. Once the seventh floor is completed, Manoj Construction Private Limited will say to you as a buyer that, boss, check the seventh floor. Once you check it, he will say, okay, I'm satisfied. Invoice will be created by the supplier. He will approve it, give the 33% payment. Then once the eighth floor is completed, same thing, a new invoice will be created by the supplier. He will approve it, 33% of the payment will be done to the supplier. And then the 10th floor is completed over there. What will happen? Then he will ask the supplier over there, in this case, Manoj Construction Worker Limited, to raise the invoice for the rest of the amount. And then he will approve it and do the payment. That is nothing but the statement of work. Exactly. Yeah, and that integration is also totally different. So that we will discuss in our next session. Yeah, and that particular thing will require too much of time. Yeah. It's not a 1 hour over there. I think we discussed this particular thing, guys, buyer, supplier, and worker over there. So what I will ask over here is, Sanket, like, excuse me, not only you, I think everybody over there, you need to go through this demo recording over there. Yeah, this is a totally new concept over there. Yeah, we discussed in detail over there. What do you mean by worker? What do you mean by worker? What do you mean by supplier over there? Okay, and all those particular thing, I think not only you, Ankit, but everybody should go ahead and watch the recording. This recording is anyhow will be provided to all of you guys over there. So please go through the recording. And once you come for our first session, okay, so there you will understand much more in depth over there. Yeah. As of now, what I will suggest is, like, please go through the recording of this demo session. That is required over there. But in the first session, a lot of your doubts and other things you will see is slowly, slowly getting reduced and removed also. Exactly. So you have to all go through this recording of the session. Why? Because this is a totally new thing. Yeah. Any other queries, Sanket? Yeah. Welcome, Ankit. Welcome. Yeah. So let us do one thing. Let us conclude our demo session for today, guys, and then we will all next meet in our first session. Yeah, the first session is basically, you can say, like, much more in depth we are going to go. And let me tell all of you guys, these sessions are going to be not too much tough, but I will say a little bit challenging for all of you guys. Why? Because the whole concept is totally different. The whole process is totally different. So what I will need from all of you guys is your participation, your full cooperation. So whenever we are trying to learn something, you also have to put a lot of hard work over there. Why? Because just attending this session, you will not understand full things. Why? Because at least 2 to 3 times previously in your Ariba session, I have said at least one time you should go through the recording. Why? Because you were knowing about this process. But here, I will ask all of you guys, at least 2 times you have to go through each of this recording. At least, not one time, 2 times. So there, you have to put up more hard work over there. And right now, the opportunities are going to be good. So put some more hard work over there. Get the success early on. Why? See, saturation will not happen for the next 4 to 5 years in Fieldglass. This is totally new, very new over there. So use this opportunity, learn this thing, change out your profile over there. Make yourself an advanced procurement guy over there within SAP rather than just a normal procurement guy over there. Hey, I know only Ariba. There you can basically change out your career over there, and you can say ERP Ariba is there, but I am also able to take care of field loss. That means instead of taking care of the normal procurement, that is my secondary work right now. My primary work is advanced procurement. I can take care of that thing. That will add a lot of value in your CV, especially in 2021, 2022, 2023 over there. You don't have to wait till 2023. 2021 is more than enough. Yeah. So we will need all of your coordination. All of you need to put a lot of hard work also over there. Then only this will succeed, guys. As I have told all of you guys in your Ariba session also, we will also put a lot of hard work. You also have to put a lot of hard work, and especially in this case of field loss. Then only it will become a success. Okay. So let us conclude our session for today. We'll meet once again. In this week only, we are going to have our first session, either on Thursday or on Friday morning. Yeah. So that particular link will be sent by our sales consultant to all of you guys over there. Okay. So once again, thanks, Nikita, for conducting this session. And thanks all of you guys for participating in our session. Don't worry, on the first session, all of you will basically get the link over there in one day, in advance over there for our first session. Yeah. And I will hope and expect from all of you guys, before that first session, please go through this recording of this demo session at least once. Yeah. So once again, thank you guys for participating in our demo session, and hope to see you soon, all of you, in our first session. Yeah. So let us conclude our session, our demonstration for today, guys. We meet once again in our first session. I think either on Thursday morning or on Friday morning, either or. Yeah. Thank you, guys. Yeah. Let's conclude our session for today.